of the famous lamp was first switched on in 1923. This table lamp became famous the world over as the Wagenfeld or Bauhaus lamp. Renowned museums, such as the Museum of Modern Art in New York, give pride of place to this symbol of the Bauhaus movement. It looks and feels like an industrial product, but a lot of manual labor went into it. Wagenfeld lamps represented a revolution in modern furnishing. Industrial design found its way into living rooms. The simple combination of glass and metal and the rejection of any kind of embellishment was a daring innovation.
What's really remarkable about it is that there's nothing remarkable about it. Its simplicity makes it beautiful.
The lamp was the perfect embodiment of the creative and artistic philosophy of Bauhaus. In the first version, the electric cable ran through the glass shaft and was clearly visible. It was modeled on the petroleum lamp.
There was a development phase with this lamp as well. There were several attempts, based on trial and error, to develop a suitable glass dome for the lamp. The ideal design brought together stereometrical basic forms, such as cylinders, globes, and plates. They began with a simple half-globe glass lampshade, because that had a more austere effect. The problem was that the spherical opal glass shade would, after a short time, crack, because the light bulb sat directly underneath the glass.
The setback wasn't all that surprising. The metal workers at Bauhaus built lamps, but were not well versed in the complexities of lighting. Jakob Jucker and Wilhelm Wagenfeld were silversmiths and had little understanding of electricity.
Wagenfeld saw this lamp as more than just another light fixture. Even when the lamp was turned off, it still had an aesthetic quality. As he once put it so nicely, when a lamp is turned off, it shouldn't just sit there hideously, like an oven in the summer.
For a long time, the lamp was just for connoisseurs. Originally, only 50 were produced. Mass production and distribution of the lamps only started after the Second World War. The design won its first prize in 1982. Berlin collector Manfred Ludewig owns one of the rare 1924 originals. He says the Wagenfeld lamp represents a philosophy.
In the first half of the 1920s, this lamp managed to precisely convey this way of thinking without being revolutionary. It was all about aesthetics, of course, and they conveyed their message effectively. That's why the lamps are still successful today. But these days, they're nothing more than a status symbol. They're the standard issue in the offices of dentists and lawyers. These people don't really understand the significance of the designs.
Of all the Bauhaus products, there are only a handful of items that have a similarly powerful aesthetic as these lamps. For example, the seamless tubular steel Vassili lounge chair by Marcel Breuer, or Marianne Brandt's little teapot. Other than those, there aren't too many such objects.
The Wagenfeld lamp is recognized by people all around the world. Despite its conquering of the mass market, it has remained a unique international design icon, real art that endures.